Tom Mongoose McEwen. That's right. All right, Mary, thank you for coming out. Appreciate it.
Hello, everybody. Looks like there's a few people in my age bracket here. I got a defibrillator in my car. My ambulance parked right outside. I thought I'd make a little money tonight. Anyway, nice everybody showed up here tonight and support these guys here. Trying to sell all this antique stuff. It's really nice and keep everything going. We're getting ready for Winter Nationals in a couple weeks in Pomona, and then heading for the March meet at Bakersfield. And as you know, or you don't know, they had a fire up there about 3 weeks ago. It burned half their tower to the ground and their trucks and everything. An electrical fire in the middle of the night. And talked to Blake and the Bowser today, and they've got the wiring fixed, and they'll be up and running for the March meet. They spent a lot of money fixing that thing. That one race a year, they kind of live off that, so let's hope that the weather is good for them. And, no, my riding days have been over for a long time. I just, I drive up there until they take my license away from me. No, my cars are in, I got a couple of them in Garlitz Museum in Florida. Got two of them at the Dan Chuck Museum over here in Santa Ana. The 57 Chevy's over there in their showroom, along with the 84 Corvette. And got the car that we sold it. Right, 2 years ago over in Scottsdale. Yeah, we sold the two big haulers with the cars on the back. And the Hendricks guy bought them, the NASCAR guy. Hendricks, the NASCAR guy, right. He bought them and put them in his collection, plus he has a couple of, whole bunch of car dealerships, and he puts them there and all that kind of stuff. So I just talked to him a little while ago, and he said hello to everybody, and he's restoring a Super Snake Dragster now with a Hemi in it, and hopes to have it done by October for Bakersfield. And other than that, a bunch of the old timers are coming to Pomona. The Winter Nationals are going to have a signing of a bunch of the old flame car guys. I know McCullough and a bunch of guys are going to be there, so out in the back. So other than that, it's fun that I come by here every now and then to check out all the old stuff, and even bought some t-shirts. The other day back there, I sell t-shirts. That's just what I need to do, is buy some more t-shirts. Right? So anyway, they had some nice old shirts and everything. Just looking at these cars in here brings back a lot of memories, because a lot of us had it at one time, and of course, maybe they weren't as nice as these restored cars, but, oh man, that's hard to, I drove so many cars that I started racing 1953 at Santa Ana Drag Strip with my mother's 53 Oldsmobile, which is now the John Wayne Airport, and C.J. Hart, and the Flag Starters, and all that kind of stuff. So that's kind of where I started, and went from there to all over, drove all kinds of different cars and stuff. So it'd be hard to pick one car. It really would be of all the different ones that I drove. And you know, all of them had memories and won certain races and had more meaning. I know that when I, in 1978, when I lost my middle son, Jamie, to leukemia when he was 13, and we won the Indy race with the English leather silk and black Corvette and beat Perdomo in the final there, which is the movie is about. That's very meaningful to me. But it's just one of the good cars that I drove over the years, from the stoppers up to the funny cars, the dragsters. I drove about every kind of car that they had at the drag strip, and it's just fun reliving this stuff and going back. And as long as we've got our memories, we can still remember the old days and the fun times. That's what it's all about. So this kind of place helps keep that alive. And I appreciate these guys sticking their necks out having a place like this. And I'm sure they don't make a lot of money. I'm sure they just get by here. So if you can help them here, I appreciate that. And enjoy yourselves tonight. And thanks for having me. And I hope you enjoy the movie. Thank you so much. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Tom. I appreciate that. So without any further ado, it's about 20 after. Why don't we get started and watch the put the movie on? What do you think? Now, I think this is our first movie night, so let's see how this thing works.
Thank you for watching, and be sure to visit Blacktop Depot in the historic C.W. Moss Building in Old Town Orange, California.